Hello everyone, I hope you're doing good and welcome back to my channel. My channel is Harsha Sipani and I do food and product photography for all the clients based locally and globally. Product photography can be really overwhelming if you don't know where to start from. So today we're going to talk about this pretty wallet that's right here on the stand, and I'm going to walk you through how I'm going to take pictures of the same with using portable light, and I'll walk you through all the lights and all the equipment that we are going to use for this particular shoot. So stay tuned guys, we're going to talk everything in detail with this particular YouTube video. So for this shoot, I'm going to use a window backlight, but I obviously don't have that surrounding right here. So I'm going to project it from this particular light. So the light that I'm using right now is Lanlight FS60B, and it's also going to be mounted to this projection attachment. And you also get these with this particular part like this, and you have different styles or designs that you can attach this to. Basically, you just have to clip this in like this and then insert it back in the projection over here. This could be a hassle, but okay. Now we're going to switch the light on and adjust the way we want it on our backdrop. Now you can see that this is quite blurry, so I'm going to adjust the height or length that I need. So basically you can move the setting how you want, and now you can see that it's not on focus, so I'm going to like adjust to get that on focus. And if you are looking for a blurry look, then I would just blur it out. Now for this particular shoot, I want it a little blurry, so I'm gonna keep that on and adjust the height a bit more. I set this slightly out of focus right here, and I'm also gonna add a blue gel to this to create that moody image. So that goes right here, and you can see how beautiful that color is looking right now, and I can adjust a little more. So now it looks like a window, and I want it a little blurry. Now I'm going to take out my camera and adjust the look that I need. So for this particular shoot, I'm going to do Nikon Z5, and I'm going to switch my lens to a 85mm lens. Now, usually I would never use a 85mm lens for a product shoot. Usually it's a 50mm or a 105mm lens. But for this shoot, I'm gonna go with 85mm because I want the background a little blurry. I switch it on. Now I'm going to adjust it to the tripod and make sure that the light and the wallet is all aligned correctly. Now the first thing I do is always set my aperture. So I really want this entire wallet to be in good focus. So I'm going to set my aperture at somewhere f9 or f8, but depends on what exactly you're looking for. Now since my wallet is slightly tilted, I need more focus, so I need more aperture. So obviously I'm going to go for the higher number, f9. Now once you set that aperture and you have your ISO set to 100, I basically always have my ISO set to 100, especially if I'm working with artificial lights. I just want to like have crispy clear pictures and have no grains basically. Now once that is set, I have my shutter speed at 1/200, and let's take a picture and see how that goes. You can see that the picture is absolutely dark with just that ambient light in the back. I think that's the look and that's the exact setting that I want to go with to begin with. Now we're going to add a few artificial lights. Those are going to be like really portable small lights that are usually used for product photography, especially if I want to highlight those small bits or pieces in the picture itself. Now for this shoot, I'm going to use this light that I got from Amazon. It's called Yulanzi, and this one is from Zio. Now these are great portable lights, and if you see, I'm going to highlight this portion of the wallet and this portion of the wallet with these two lights. Now to this, I'm also going to use Nanline power tube, and I'm going to highlight this lower portion of the wallet for this particular shoot. And you can see how I do that, and I'm going to have help of my beautiful intern right here. I don't know if you're coming in the frame. Can you lower down? Can you bend and say hi? Okay, so she is going to be helping us with the shoot, and she's helping me for the product shoot as of now here. Now we're going to hold the lights at different parts, and you can see how those are going to help and highlight all the shots basically. Now let's turn this light right here. And you see it's really bright, and if you really don't want that brightness, then we can just dim it down. Now we're going to highlight this top portion of the wallet. Hold on. So the wallet is upside down. Now we're going to just place it back in position. Now the reason why I made this wallet upside down is I wanted to highlight the brand name here. It's from Exter, and that's the reason why I flipped it upside down. And this is actually how the wallet is supposed to be. The logo is turning up and everything is, I think everything is looking perfect now. So I'm going to angle it in a way that I like, and now she's going to highlight this portion with this portable light. Now I'm using a robot arm that I got from Amazon for this particular shoot, because I think we will be holding other lights as well. And basically we wanted the product to be still because it's going to be a composite shot towards the end. Now you can see how that highlight is going to make a difference. Can you shift it up? Yeah. Now I still don't see the product, so I'm going to tilt it towards me a little bit. And here is the shot. So you can see that the brand is slightly visible, but I would like it to be a little more facing towards me. But that's a lot. Okay. This might work, but we'll see. Now, exactly this is the reason why I wanted it to be at a higher f-stop, because you see how the wallet is tilting towards me. Oh yeah. Can you bring the light closer? Okay, now you can see how that is going to highlight. You see that the wallet is really highlighted on the edge over here. Move up. Yeah, there. Okay, now I'm going to light this light up, and I'm going to show how I'm going to brighten up the edges here with this. So can you switch off that, and we'll see how this helps. You see that edge, the top edge, that's exactly what I needed for this shoot. Now I'm going to switch off this, and I'm going to show you what I'm going to do with this light. So this power tube has like variety of lights hues, but basically we only want the white shades. Now I'm going to use this really close, so it creates that gradient that I'm looking for, and I'm going to have it in focus. Now you can tilt the tube. Now you can see that's a beautiful gradient. Now it's a very small gradient. I want bigger gradient. So maybe I'm going to tilt the tube a little more towards the light, and it should do the trick. You see that? It, now the gradient is bigger, and maybe I'm going to highlight a little more. And that's it. Now, few things that are absolutely important when we do a composite shot is take a before and after shot. Now, since I've already done the after shot, I'm going to take a before shot. Let's move the wallet further out, further out. Now this was a before shot. Basically I'm just going to like cut the composite shots, and I'm going to bring it together to this particular backdrop. Now you might come back, you might see that it completely like goes out of focus when you move the subject. So all you have to do is set the focus and then set the camera to a manual mode, and now move the subject out of the frame little more, and then take a picture. And that's it. You pretty much have the backdrop before and after shot. And I took three shots. That is this edge, this edge, this edge. Now with the product, also remember to clean your product nicely before shoot using your gloves and other equipment, because it gets, you will have to do a lot of post-processing, so that will be too much. So make sure you do that, and here is the final result. I hope you guys like it. Using portable lights for this particular shoot, and I'll walk you through all the light and all the equipments that we are going to use for this particular shoot. So stay tuned. Product photography can be very overwhelming for those who have. Hi guys, today we're going to do a sleek wallet photography, and we're going to see how we're going to highlight the parts of the wallet to make sure that the wallet is looking very sleek. Hello again, my name is Harsha Sipani. I'm a commercial photographer based in North Carolina, and I do light itself. So I'm also going to use a small